This is the Schmo with the Pro 20-0, George Forocious Kambosas. You go from Manny Pacquiao's sparring partner to the man, the Undisputed at 135. How we doing?
I'm doing great, man. That was beautiful. That rhymes there. That could be your next rap, album in there. So I feel great. I feel very focused of what I've achieved, but there's so much more to go now.
We appreciate that, man. Now talk to the Schmo for a second. Let's revisit the fight because you've been doing that a lot, but we're just going to ask you one question, man. Talk to the Schmo about going from round one to round two. Obviously, you dropped the guy. And where was your mindset going into round two for the confidence to get the job done and finish that fight at MSG?
Look, I knew that I was going to put him down. I knew that possibly I'd take him out in that first round because his emotion and him coming flying in, thinking that he'll take me out in a round, it would work against him. And if you look at prior interviews, I said that. I lined him up perfect, a shot that we have worked on months and months, and it changed the fight. It really made him respect me and say, wait a minute, Kambosas can punch. Where did that shot come out of? Because it was just like a rocket. So the game plan as soon as that happened was go back to what we do best, round by round. Let's break this kid down. Like I said, I was fully prepared for 12 rounds. I was even prepared to take it old school and do 15 rounds. So even 15 rounds, I don't think he lasts 15 rounds, but I would have still been there bouncing on my toes and ready to win the fight.
Now you're here on a media tour. We got Haney and Diaz Jr. And then you got Gervonta Davis against Isaac Cruz. Which fight are you looking forward to watching the most? Because you're going to be in person for both these fights.
Yeah, look, both of them. Both great fights. Great for the 135-pound division. Got my eyes on all the winners. And, it's a blessing to be here as the emperor, the number one, the guy who is at the top of the division.
But all the guys on paper, who do you think's most deserving right now to date with all the accolades to face you next, right now to date?
I really can't say that right now because they all have important fights. So right now they might be deserving, but, in a week or so after their fights, they might not even be in the picture anymore. So, as long as they do their thing, then we'll sit down and make the right guy. And the most exciting, entertaining fight is what I want.
What do you make of fellow Australian Leon Paro fighting on the undercard of the Jake Paul against Fury undercard?
Yeah, this is his breakout fight. Really good kid, very talented and, taking the risk to come out here, preparing out here. And, I'm very excited for his career, and especially this first pro fight in the U.S. in America.
And obviously you were a major underdog. The Schmo looked at the bet online odds before your fight.
You jump on him.
Yeah, the Schmo's barber made big time money. What's your message for all the underdogs out there who ever doubt you that say you can't get the job done, but you get the job done?
Just believe. Believe in yourself. No matter what, the odds are, against all odds, believe in yourself. And, if you have that vision and that focus and that tunnel vision, with your belief, you can do whatever you want.
And what was the best advice Manny the Pac-Man Pacquiao gave you to date leading into the fight?
Oh, look, there's so much, but one of the things he said that stood out was in 2018, I believe it was for the Broner fight. He goes, you're ready to be world champion. You're champion right now. And I said, not yet. My time will come because I knew I had to bide my time. And that time came. And obviously everyone saw the tweet that he put out there. Shows the respect we have between each other. And he did. He did shape me, to help me in that fight as well.
He's the pro. I'm the Schmo. The man at 135, George Kambosas. The MGM Grand Garden Arena. We're out.